We're here at the CES 2023, and we have a very, very exciting partnership with TDK and Texas Instruments, which TDK is revealing a very, very new groundbreaking sensor technology that I just found out. So, Michael, can you tell me more about this new product that you're revealing today?
Yeah, sure, Marian. First of all, it's a pleasure to be here at the CES together with you guys from Texas Instruments. It's the first time that we are showing a new product together.
Yeah.
And I would like to go a little bit into the history of this project.
Yes, please, please do that.
Because
it's a long, long time, right?
A couple of years ago,
yeah,
with the idea between the management of both companies. And of course, with the expertise of Texas Instruments and the expertise of TDK to create more value for our customers for condition-based monitoring,
right,
industrialization, IoT, using the expertise. And I think what's quite amazing is that from the idea, from a very wide market, which back then we already saw coming, we have today a product which both companies are already using internally.
Correct.
And which I think here at CES is getting some traction and very high level of attention.
Yeah, I think you're absolutely right. I think, you know, what is really amazing to me is that we went from the component level, right? We have an SoC, wireless communication. It's a wireless sensor, right? The product is a wireless sensor. They can do, as you mentioned, condition-based monitoring with a lot of sensors from TDK. And we combine all of that at unique software on top of it to run at very low power and measuring multiple different aspects that's going on the factory floor, for example, in production lines, right? Whether it's in the semiconductor industry, and we run our own factory, so we know what we're talking about,
yeah,
but also many, many other factories out there. So can you talk a little bit more about the sensors and the functionality of the device that we're,
sure,
we're providing to the customers?
I mean, this product, if we compare it to the reality before this product, enables the engineers to have real-time understanding of the conditions of their machinery. Let's say an engine.
Yeah?
And instead of having an engineer running and testing and verifying the conditions of the equipment and making sure that everything is under control, this device that we co-produced is easy to use, doesn't have any cables, can be used in areas which are difficult to access,
right,
and is ongoingly transmitting key data to the engineers who on the dashboard function then can verify with whether everything is under control. And beyond that, we can use it also to verify if anything is running into an area where you need to start replacing equipment.
Right.
Yeah. So this aspect of looking a little bit into the future and replacing equipment at the right time is also given here.
Okay. Very, very interesting. I think the one thing I would like to point out about this product and we're very, very proud about is using the TDK sensors together with the TI SoC, which is based on a 2.4 gigahertz technology, is actually running on a TI specific process node in our own factories. And that process node has a very, very low power consumption across the temperature range, because those machinery that you described, Michael, they're going from across a temperature range, right, depending on the utilization. So you want to make sure that the low power performance is consistent about the temperature range. And there's no other process out there besides the TI semiconductor process that allows you to run at those low level of power consumption together with the TDK sensors.
Yeah, today we have accelerometers and digital thermometers inside, plus batteries, of course,
right,
to keep the power up. The interesting thing about this, I think, is we can, looking into the future, combine any type of sensors and applications necessary to customize it further to the needs to different areas.
Right.
And I think that makes this very unique.
Now, we talked about the collaboration and the product a little bit. I know you have a demo here for us. So let's look at what this product actually does.
Sure, absolutely, Marian. Let's take a look into what i3 micro module can really do. And for that, we have Ito-san here, who is taking care of our demo at the CES show. Ito-san, show us what can this micro module really do for us.
Okay.
Please.
Here is demo. In this top of this module, there is a same sensor module in it. and then this is an already normal state and connects the wires with a mesh network. Then I turn the motor speed up, then the status is anomaly. So please show the demo of the red LED turn red. Then I made the anomaly state. So inside the HDAI detects the anomaly state, and then LED turn red. This is the demo.
Excellent, very good. So the vibration of the motor is triggering the module to detect that the motor is not running smooth, right?
Yes.
And then we're using a unique mesh networking capability that's enabled by the device wirelessly.
Yes.
To condition monitor what's going on the motor and on the machinery. Very good. So Michael, where can this take us? I know you have a lot of interaction with customers. There's many different sectors that are looking for condition-based monitoring. What is your experience so far after the first day of CES show, revealing that product?
I think that so far, both of our companies have been using it in our own factories.
Correct.
And we are testing data.
Yeah.
We must not forget that this device needs to build up intelligence.
Right.
And that takes a little bit of time in the environment. Yeah. So the anomaly can only be detected if the software reaches certain thresholds.
Right.
I think that the next step here at the CES that we are observing is we are receiving many requirements from different customers from different markets who can envision this kind of application in their own factories. Beyond that, looking a little bit more into the future, I think TDK wants to further expand on the artificial intelligence part, on the algorithm part.
Right.
Yeah. Of course, we will try to do in certain applications the module smaller. We will try to reduce the energy consumption.
Right.
We will try to adapt to the required profiles. But I think the most important thing is really artificial intelligence, the algorithms behind it.
That's very interesting that you say that, and it fits very well into our partnership because we're focusing very much on building the right compute functionality inside the devices to be able to run those algorithms, right? Whether it's hardware accelerated or it's software based. But as you mentioned, we're using it in our own factories. We're learning a lot of what is actually needed on the edge to drive artificial intelligence, which of course is a huge buzz, but this shows that it's becoming real.
Absolutely, and again, let's not forget, we started this with an idea. We have a product now, which we are using internally. We have customers aligned to use it more, to use the existing product, and we already have ideas for the next generation of products using another level of intelligence. Maybe I can say also that yesterday we released the information that we acquired Quizo, which is an artificial intelligence machine learning specialist, which is going to help us exactly with this area to further improve the capabilities of the algorithm side.
Excellent, very good. Michael, we're very proud that everything comes together from the base layer of the chipset itself, compute functionality, the sensors from TDK, the software on top of it, the network protocol stack, as Ito-san showed us with the mesh networking capabilities to give the robustness inside of factories, and driving it to the next level with artificial intelligence. So we're very excited about what this future will bring for us both.
And I want to highlight also that we expect to continue collaborating with Texas Instruments, and we hope that both of us can contribute to IoT, to condition-based monitoring together. Thank you very much, Marian, to be here.
Thank you, Michael.
At our booth here today. And hope to see you next year again to talk about the next generation of products.
Excellent. Thank you so much, Michael.
Thank you.
Have a good show.
Thank you very much. Thank you.